I am, with pain in my heart, going to pass. It's very dramatic. I did hear her. I've heard. That's better. Well, hello my beauties and welcome to my channel. If you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 43 from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And today another Let's Talk Makeup new makeup releases. So yeah, this series is based on Samantha March's Will I Buy It series. Her playlist will be down in the description box, and she was also kind enough to create a community playlist where creators such as myself can add these types of videos to. That one is also in my description box, as are my sources that I use on Instagram to make this video happen for you every single week. The products I will mention will be there as well. The makeup that I have on my face will be there, which I filmed. It's not up yet, but it is coming. It is the third look with the three looks on the Just My Luck palette by Colourpop. I don't exactly know when it will be up on my channel, but it is coming. So just, if you want to see the looks that I created, you just have to hit that big red button. Yeah, that's what I wanted to say. Was that everything I wanted to say? I think so. I don't know yet. So yeah, let me just go to the side. Where's my mouse? Oh, there. Let me kind of make sure I'm in focus. Where's my mouse thingy? Oh, there. That's the wrong side, hon. Yes, so like this. So I can put the pictures up there and yes, still be in focus. So I have my Instagram open here, and let's just jump into it. Let's start with Colourpop, because they released yet again another collection. This is the Strawberry Dreams collection. And when I heard about this, I was like, another red palette. But this is not really a strawberry palette, but it is a strawberry cream palette. So more like a milkshake, strawberry milkshake kind of thing. Or strawberry shake, that's what it's called. Never mind. So at first I was like, And then I looked at it more closely, and I actually really like this collection. I have watched, what's she called again? This is so bad, but I watched a review, or yeah, review, swatches, all that goodness on this collection. For the life of me, I cannot remember her name. But I will link it down below. I will put it in the screen as well. I will link it down below, because she just shows you everything that is in the collection, as she does with every collection that Colourpop comes out with, by the way. So if you want to know how those collections look, just subscribe to her and you will know. But I was actually pretty impressed by the color story of this red palette, because it is not, you can make a red look, but you can also make a peachy look. And you know, I think it's pretty, and you have no pressed glitter in the center. I wish they made it a shimmer though, instead of a matte with sparkly things in it. I don't know the function of a matte with sparkly things, because it's just basically another matte. But yeah, that's me. I do really like also the pressed blushes that are in there. I think they are very pretty, and the Super Shock shadows looked gorgeous. So yeah, I'm still kind of eyeing the orange palette, to be quite honest. But on the other hand, I just got two new palettes, and I have a few palettes to get through. So this one and the orange one are on my wish list. I just don't know if I will grab them now or later, but they are definitely on my wish list. Okay, let's go to Makeup Obsession now, because they showed two new products. The So Lit Highlight Palette and the Sweet Like Cherry Eyeshadow Palette. I am not really a highlighter palette or a blush palette kind of girl, to be quite honest with you. The only highlighter palette I frequently use is one from BH Cosmetics. And the only reason I frequently use that is because I use it in my eye looks. So, yeah. And the Sweet Like Cherry Eyeshadow Palette, it looks pretty. Not gonna lie. but it also does not really grab me. The Obsession formula, I have one Obsession palette here. The formula is really, really nice though. So yeah, if you like this, kind of your goldeny pinky palette, pinky red, whatever palette, yeah, go grab it. I wanted to mention it. Okay, next we go to Makeup Revolution. Launching next week, that's this week, yeah. Our Conceal and Fix Loose Setting Powders in 10 shades, no flashback and talk-free and water-resistant. So yeah, I'm actually kind of interested in these, if I'm being completely honest. So yeah, you never know. Maybe I will grab one. I'm not in a hurry though, but you never know. The next thing that they are launching is the Conceal and Define Hydrate Concealer. And that is, yeah, it is officially launching on August the 14th. You will have 50 skin true shades infused with hyaluronic acid. And they also added a pump applicator. Oh, they are launching the concealer and the foundation. I thought, why do you need a concealer with a pump? But yeah, so they are launching the Conceal and Hydrate Foundation and the Conceal and Hydrate Concealer. I am actually really interested in these. I have yet to try their Conceal and Define Foundation, the original one. The concealer is okay. It is not... The formula is too thick and gloopy for underneath my eyes. I prefer a lighter formula, especially now in summertime. But I actually am very interested in these, just so you know. So maybe. They are on my wish list. So yeah. Next is NYX Cosmetics, and these I'm actually really interested in. These are the new Lip Lingerie Push-Up Long Lasting Lipstick Collection. Wow. I have on my lips today one of these, a turned up one. I really, really like the formula on these. So I'm actually quite curious because the colors in here look very, very pretty. So yeah, I don't know when they will come here. They retail for $9 each. I don't know when they will come here. But when they do and I see some, I will swatch. And it could very well be that I will pick some up. Because yeah, pretty. Pretty. Okay. But next is from Sigma, a new eyeshadow palette. It is called Enchanted. It launches the 13th of August on their site and it retails for $49. It looks pretty. It looks like half neutral, half colorful, but a bit more muted. I think it looks gorgeous, if I'm being totally honest with you. But for $49, I am going to pass. But the colors look really pretty. So I actually cannot wait to see reviews on this because, yeah, from my understanding, the Sigma eyeshadows are pretty good. Oh yeah, I expect someone can make gorgeous colors or gorgeous eye looks with this palette. So yeah, next let's go to, what's this? Terra Moon. Yeah, so Terra Moon Cosmetics and Amanda Organa teamed up again to make this stunning collection of neon eyeshadow singles. But you can also put them in a palette, I think. They are very pretty, though. And it looks to be that some are shimmers. I've not tried anything from Terra Moon Cosmetics. But let me know if you have. Okay, let's go to Makeup a Murder Cosmetics. I showed you a sneak peek of their next eyeshadow palettes a few weeks back. Which is called the Crime Scene Trace Evidence Volume 1. It is officially available now, and they have also launched a crime scene eyeshadow tape. So I think that's for underneath your eyes. I think that's fantastic. But yeah, so you see the eye swatches here. I also have a picture of the inside of the palette. The eye swatches look really, really nice. And I like the fact that it is, well, basically a curated palette. If you can mix the shadows on your eye to create different colors, you can. I really like it. You have, yeah, you basically your rainbow and then a black and a white. See, you don't need a big ass painterly palette. You can get it with a 9 pen as well. Let's go to Glamour Empire. No, Model Rock Lashes. They are based in Sydney, Australia, and they are launching their graffiti makeup collection. And I think this looks so cute and so different. The palette look like, those paint swatches when you go to a hardware store, or at least that's where we go for our paint, usually. You have those paint strip cards, you know, that you can match up with. That's what these are. I think they're cute. I think this is a fun collection, to be quite honest with you. Can I see what is in here? No. So you have an eyeshadow palette, you have some brushes, face elixir, lip piece looks like. I think it's fun. Let me see. What else do I here? Color playbook, that's what the palette is called. Oh, okay. So one of the that black tube that you see is an eyeliner. Instead of a pot, you have kind of a squeezy tube. So it doesn't dry out as fast. I don't know if that will work, but I think the idea is fun. Just so you know. So yeah, let me know if you have tried anything from this brand, if you know of the brand, especially if you live in Australia, because this looks to be a very, very fun brand overall. Okay, let's go to September Rose Cosmetics. A few months back, or was it last year, she sneaked the fact that there would be a slush too. Then the brew happened and everyone was like, "Oh, that's the second slush palette," but it wasn't. Now, however, we do have the slush number two. This, when I first saw this, it gave me slush one vibes without the excess shades. So you basically have five shades less in this one than in the original slush palette. The color story from the picture looks very, very similar. The only difference is that this is an all matte palette. In my humble opinion, if you have the slush one, I don't think you will need the slush two. But if you do not have the first slush because you maybe thought it was too big or there were too many similar shades, you can always check out this palette. I do have a discount code with them. It is down in my description box. It's not affiliated though. It's just to save you some money. The colors look really pretty. It looks to be, from the picture, colors that are a little bit further apart. So the criticism that she got on the first slush, she took for this one. I just wish that it wasn't an all matte palette, because personally I do not gravitate towards all matte palettes. I know you can spruce it up with shimmers, highlighters, or other shimmer shadow whatever. I actually would love to try this formula and compare it with the slush one. But I just don't think that I will get as much use out of this palette as I do with the slush one. Just because the fact that there are shimmers there. And I prefer a combination of mattes and shimmers in my palette. So yeah, let me know down below if you are excited about this. If you are getting it, let me know down below. The next thing is something that I was really, really interested in until I heard that it was limited edition. That's this from Kaleidos Makeup. This is dropping August the 13th. I have seen swatches, I have seen reviews, or at least being used. Agnieszka posted a video where she swatched the shadows. I will link it down below. Annette from Annette's Makeup Corner posted a video where she used both eyeshadow palettes. I will link that video down below as well. These look so, so, so pretty, but they are limited edition. And they are not sure if they will stay limited edition. So it's kind of the first batch, you know, that is limited edition technically. With the option to bring them back if they are very, very popular. And I am kind of sad about that. Because I really, really like these. But solely based on the fact that they are limited edition, I am, with pain in my heart, going to pass. Because, yeah, I cannot then recommend them, you know. Then there's just a small window that I can use it on my channel, and I'm going to pass. There are more in the Futurism collection that grab my attention, but yeah, unless they say it is not going to be limited edition, then I will probably be all over it. But for now, solely because they are limited edition, I am going to pass. And I'm going to drool over every video that I see done with these two. But yeah. It's very dramatic. Next, let's go to Kylie Cosmetics. And I actually never mentioned Kylie Cosmetics. But I wanted to show this. Because this eyeshadow palette kind of blew me away. When I saw a picture of this, I did not expect it to be Kylie Cosmetics. I think this is a very pretty palette. I'm not going to get it because I think that it is way too expensive. For me personally though. But yeah, there is more in this collection. It's launching the 10th. I don't know if that is when today is the 5th. So it is launching this week. Let's see Kylie Cosmetics then to see what is in the collection. Because I don't know. Let's see. Can I see what's in there? Stories for the... Oh, really? Just say what's in the freaking collection already. You stupid... Anyway, you see it here. They're probably lipsticks and blushes and highlighters and all that goodness. I am in no mood to go and search. And I wanted to talk about the eyeshadow palette anyway. So it does not really matter, does it? But yeah, I think it's pretty. I'm not going to get it. But let me know your thoughts down below. Okay, Amy Hart's Beauty is next. This is a picture of the foodie bundle. And I love the fact that she put a big ass knife beside the palette. I like that sense of humor. The eyeshadow palettes, the pigments, lippies, lippy scrubs. It looks really, really pretty. It is live already. So go check them out. I have not tried anything from Amy Hart's Beauty. I did hear her. I've heard. That's better. I've heard good things about it though. So go check it out. Okay, next is Lunatic Cosmetics. They have a heart palette. And it is a heart-shaped palette, but it's not a heart-shaped palette as you will imagine it, probably. Here, you see it. It is an anatomically correct heart. I think this is so fun. I like the aesthetics of Lunatic Cosmetics. I can get it here in the Netherlands without any issues online, though. I do think, however, they are very pricey. For the amount of shades that are in the palettes, I've heard mixed reviews on it, and... I do really like the aesthetics that they have. I just think they are overpriced. But that's my personal opinion. I really do like this though. Because this is something that I have not seen before. Lunatic Labs, that is why I like them. That's also why I love the aesthetics of Makeup and Murder. Just because it is so different from what most brands are doing. This is available now and it retails for $31. And that is what I mean. You get 5 shades... You get a palette, and then $31. I don't know, people. I don't know. I think it's too much for this. But that is me personally. I do really like it though. But yeah, it's for that price, not for me. Let's go to Too Faced. We are in the middle of summer. They are already sneak peeking their holiday collection and it is gingerbread themed, like last year. The gingerbread palette that you can get now because they released it for their, Christmas in July. They are going to bring back, so I kind of want it. I've kind of wanted it ever since I saw it. I don't know how much I will use it, but if they keep kind of re-releasing their gingerbread palette throughout the year... It's not really limited edition, is it? So maybe I am going to get it. Because I do really like it. But holiday releases now already? Lord. I know we are having kind of fall weather, although it looks to be quite sunny outside now. But yeah. On the other hand, the gingerbread that we can get here, the crunchy ones... So if you are Dutch or Belgian, the pepernoten, especially the chocolate covered ones, oh, I can eat those all year round. So yeah, I would eat gingerbread all year round because I basically do. The crispy one, that is. But yeah. What do you think? Let me know down below what your thoughts are. Let's go to Ofra because they have released an Area 51 collection. Is that because there was that thing that someone kind of... called people to storm Area 51. Like, that's where all the secrets are. Yeah, right. Because they will not shoot all of you. I thought that was hilarious. I laughed so hard on that. It was just insane. But anyway, they are releasing an Area 51 collection. The highlighter is in Neptune. It's an icy lavender. Retails $35. The Area 51 lip set will retail for $39. You get the color Utopia, Emerald City and Wonderland. What the hell does that have to do with Area 51? Unless you kind of think of Area 51 as a fairy tale as well. Then I can kind of get behind it. But yeah. Maybe they should have called it a fantasy collection then. I don't know. An icy lavender highlighter I like in an eyeshadow palette. Does that make any sense? It is not for me on my face. It's not that. I do like the lippies though. They look like kind of shimmery. I like it. I have an offer lippy here that I got as a gift with purchase for my eyeshadow palettes. I still haven't used it yet, though. I'm going to, when I'm done filming this, I'm going to wipe this off and put that one on because I'm really curious to see how it is on the lips. But yeah, let's go to the next one, which is a sneak peek from Tarte, because they are collaborating with Sugar Rush, and you see it here. It's probably going to be kind of a honey palette. I hope that the shades that you see on top are actually the shades that are in the palette. I think that would be pretty. So yeah, I don't know. It will probably be a kind of a Tarte. Tarte can be kind of boring, I think. So yeah, browns and such. And then maybe one yellow, an orange, and I don't know. If I know any more, I will let you know. Okay, let's go to, is this the last one? Yeah, this is the last one from Red Rose Lashes. It is their Summer Night collection. I had not heard of this brand before. They are based in California, but I thought this was very pretty, so I wanted to mention it anyway. Let me see. The Summer Nights palette retails for $25. The Summer Nights lash pack for $42. Why is that so? You get three pairs of lashes. Why is it $42? I don't know. Does not matter. Mine retail for €5, which is $7. So, yeah. Neon pigments are $6 each and $35 for all seven. They also have metal straws, which are $7. And then $2 will be donated to Oceana and the Ocean Cleanup, which I think is amazing. The whole bundle is valued at $116, but you can get it for $96. So yeah, let me know what you think of it down below. It looks cute. Yeah, it's not grabbing my attention enough, but that is also kind of because I am a little bit in eyeshadow overload because of the fact that I have two new palettes and still have some that I have to film with. I think I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 palettes that I have to film 3 looks with. Minimum. So yeah. So I'm going to pass. But I did want to mention it anyway. Because I always like finding brands that I did not know of before. So let me go to the center. Where's my mousey thingy? Ah, there. Yes, now I'm in focus again. So guys, that was it. That was number 47, I think it is already. Of my Let's Talk Makeup new makeup releases. Let me know down below if you are interested in any of the products that I talked about. If you know all the brands, maybe I have surprised you with some of the brands that I mentioned today. This was it for me. I am going to sign off. I need to drink because my throat's a bit scratchy. So yeah, guys. Thank you so freaking much for watching. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening, and we'll see you soon in my next one. Bye, guys.